So you notice everyone is just a little bit under pitch in every hour. Like we moved it from G flat to F, we probably didn't leave it. You know, that sounds a little better. And so yeah, I need to be careful of where these are. So you can go from page 3. The pickup from the middle line to the bottom line of page 3. So, the D natural. A moment. So, this is a pickup to the bottom of page 3. Okay? Here's the alto C flat. Thank you. to my front being caught at the top of the stage. Although it seems that you're just singing two notes, like back and forth. Pick up to page three.
Thank you.
other and be like, not really tuning very well, you know, things like that. So it's just so you hear it clearly. You said a little on the E flat there. Okay, but it stayed in E flat. Alright, so one last time from the beginning. Okay, I'll just very lightly take this. Okay, so yeah, somewhere between just from a tuning perspective, it mainly is the problems show up in the soprano 2 and the soprano 1 part here. Even with the piano part that's written in, a lot of the dum 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 dum, but you notice dun, right, yeah, it has to match, right? Or else it's very, if it doesn't match, you hear it right away that it doesn't match because the piano keeps on. Basically, the piano keeps on playing it anyways. Oh, yeah, you know. Right, you know, it's like constant reminder, you're supposed to be here, right? In the piano. it's just something to keep in mind right there. And then, of course, for soprano one, this da 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 da. Now, of course, now that because there's two of you singing it, the challenge is you have to match, right? Of course, I know it's Maggie's first day on it, so that's okay. But
it's okay.
You get the challenge is there. I can give, just so that you get a chance to try it a few more times at least for practice. Can you try singing the two phrases? Where you do that. On page 2, let's do the one that's in the middle.
What's that?
Okay. Okay, so just the run of one, okay? Just to get track. Really effectively when it does that, because you're trying to describe a very, very still scene anyways, right? You happen to be an observer, but you really shouldn't be there, almost like that, right? And nobody else is around either. So when you do sing it in that way, where it's very little vibrato, not really much crescendo, it's actually, it almost does, not the opposite, but it's not like it's anticlimactic, but it sounds amazing. But it's very still, very, very still, Yeah. So we don't have to do too much extra to it. Just let it do its thing. You know what I mean? So it's just clear, and then it's written cleverly so that it just sort of does the crescendo anyways, even without us really doing an extra.
Thank you.
corner of your mouth down, and so it actually ends up being flat for that reason. So when you sing, when you put in the E flat. Yes, there it is. Yeah, that comes up. It's still the same word, right? But it definitely helps us with the tuning because it, at the top there, if it's pulling us down, it's really hard. So. You hear a difference, right? It's the same word, but I just pulled the other one really low, and it sounds. Right, so this is the eyebrow. You know what? It's definitely really singing with your eyebrow. Sorry, yeah, it's just true. Okay, and let's try and get that pick up this guy.